pay me interest that I would have to be paying interest on, yeah, we would love to do that.
Developer Jeff Blackard says if need be, he'll put up the $40 million to dig the North Beach Canal, as long as the city pays him back within 5 years. That still hasn't been worked out yet.
Corpus Christi has a history of that.
But as a member of the North Beach Task Force, Blackard says he's committed to the canal project, and he's not the only one.
The amount of work of people that have volunteered and money that we have put in is probably close to $1 million, maybe more.
The most important map.
Set up in a pair of war rooms provided by the Edward Schall Foundation, Blackard, his staff, and other volunteers plan their next move. That won't happen until after the city's feasibility study is finished.
When the urban engineering study gets back, we'll be in front of the city around Christmas, and soon after that, negotiate a deal with the city, and we should be off and running.
Blackard is also trying to develop Barisi Village. He understands some people may be skeptical of him because of that project's troubled history. Blackard says if he becomes an obstacle to this project, he'll gladly step back, as long as North Beach drainage gets fixed.
Somebody else can lead the North Beach project. It's not dependent on me.
Now, to highlight support from the public for his plan, Blackard told me about an Uber ride he took a couple of nights ago. The driver, as they came to North Beach, excitedly told him all about the North Beach Canal project, not knowing who Blackard was. Blackard said, quote, "When it gets to the Uber driver, we're doing something positive." Lee?
All right, thank you very much, Greg. By the way, according to Mr. Blackard, a motion to set up a tax increment reinvestment zone to help pay for canal maintenance will go before the city council next month.
Six Weather is brought to you by Aztec Chevrolet in Beeville. Visit AztecAutoplex.com. Now, the most accurate weather forecast in South Texas with Chief Meteorologist Dale Nelson.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back. Here is your Aztec Chevrolet forecast. We have had a lot drier conditions now than we did 24 hours ago, where storms were on the increase. They've been decreasing this afternoon and only isolated to stray showers. That's all we've seen today, and mostly right along the coast. So that's coming in with drier air to the north, along with this frontal system that's going to stall out, as this one did that passed through here on Monday. That has stalled out in the Gulf. The rain from yesterday is well out here in the west central Gulf of Mexico and pulling away from us, after many of us out to the west of Corpus Christi saw anywhere from 1 to 3 inches of rain. Robstown area was very wet last night and early this morning. Our evening forecast will hold at near 90 at 7 p.m. and then drop into the mid 80s near sunset, low 80s around midnight. But notice how light the winds are tonight. We'll allow under clear skies for our temperatures to drop into the low 70s. We won't see that going forward, as the winds are going to increase and dramatically raise our overnight lows. But tonight's a winner, with 80 in Port Aransas, 72 here, and 71 at Alice, George West, and Kingsville, and other locations too. With 72, calm and quiet in the morning, mostly sunny skies, sunshine and warm, and 89 at noon tomorrow. And notice the winds under 10 miles an hour. We do get a little bit of a sea breeze, hot with lots of sun, and 95 at 5 p.m. And we'll close at the high of the day tomorrow with 95 here, 91 on Mustang Island, ranging to 97 inland, and a fairly typical June day here in South Texas. This frontal system again dissipating, high pressure up to the north with cool air moving east and not south, hot air building in the west and headed this way, as is evidence on the water vapor imagery. Here's the low pressure. This is the one that went through us last night, causing all the storminess. Now the dry air was following on this northwesterly flow aloft, and this high over Baja California is going to build into the region. There it comes. That's tomorrow evening, and there it is sitting right over South Texas Friday evening. So the heat will build, and then as it passes to the east, we get this southwesterly flow, which is going to pick up our winds here in the coastal bend just in time for Father's Day and the weekend. So not good there for that. Here is the wind forecast. Very light tomorrow. East southeast 6 to 12, breezy on Friday, but windy Saturday, and definitely on Father's Day, 20 to 30 out of the south southeast. Your NEC Co-op Energy 7-day forecast, 72 tonight, 95 tomorrow, and for Flag Day, 96 Saturday. We'll dial it down with the wind on Father's Day to 94, but the heat index will be about 110 to 115 then. Isolated showers return to the area as we had today on Tuesday of next week, but no big rain in the next 7-day forecast. So I hope you got your share of rain last night and early this morning.
Sure.